the Ghostbusters. We're clever, courageous, and strong.
Hello, we are back with Bill D. Ecto 1 from the Ghostbusters. We are now in issue 20. Let me quickly take you through issue 20. We have stage 71, which is the interior section and one of the hinges of the hood of the car. We have stage 72, which is the other section of the hinge. And we have the inner roof of the car, the roof itself. Then we have in stage 73 a large part, which is the actual outer roof of the car and a screwdriver. I'm not quite sure why, but anyway. And in stage 74, we have the left fender. What are we going to do in this issue? Well, I was planning to do the hood and the left and right hood hinges. That is what we're going to do in this video. But apart from making these hinges, I also want to do some weathering both on the inside of the hood and the hinges themselves. And that's going to be a bit difficult because apart from having it heavily weathered, it still needs to function, it still needs to work, it still needs to be able to open the car hood without much trouble. So that means we are going to do some additional oil here and there after it's finished and make sure that things like these tooths of those cogs are not fully weathered, so we have a smooth opening hood but a weathered hood nonetheless. So let's get our parts and let's see how we're going to tackle this. I have the first of the hinges finished. I must say, an impressive thing to look at. The hardest part was getting the spring in place, but that has worked. So it's very tough at the moment, but here we go. So this long part is going to be added to the car frame, and this part is going to be added to the fixed to the hood itself. And the spring will make a jump up, so we need to make another one. The weight of the hood is going to pull the hood down, as far as I know it should. So as you can see, it's going to be fixed over here. Hold on, let me get it into frame. It's going to be fixed over here. So what I need to do now, I'm first going to make the other frame, sorry, the other hinge. They are marked with an R, and the other one most likely will be marked with an L. And this one also marked with an R, so there'll be no misconstruations which one goes where. And then I'm going to try to do the weathering. And if you can see, I have put oil not only on the screws, but also on every moving part. It looked like a disaster just occurred. I used several sizes of coarse salt, using the typical salt method. So what I first did, I spray painted brownish colors over here. Can you see it? Oh yeah, brownish colors over here and inside of the hood, and some brownish colors over here. I made sure that this is a bit more black than this. Then I added some other brownish and oranges colors to simulate rust. It didn't look that good, but that was never the intention. Then used some protective layer pledge over it, then watered it with a brush or a pipette with water, and then sprinkled large amounts of coarse and a little bit finer salt on it. This is the famous salt method. So what we're going to do now, we're going to spray paint this part in a semi-gloss black. We're gonna paint this part in a semi-flat black. And then when that is all finished, we're gonna wipe off all the salt particles we have over here. And that will allow us to reveal back what's beneath it. So the original brown color we had. Hopefully that will simulate
things like rust. I did the same thing. Yeah, I did the same thing here on the hinges. I'm gonna be very careful with painting it, but I think it's gonna work out. So the advantage, of course, of my method is that I never usually can get all the salt off. So what remains is not just the typical rust particles coming through, but also all the grime remaining. So the coarseness of the salt remains on the model, which makes it a bit more weathered as intended. Anyway, we're gonna now spray paint these with the blacks, and let's see what happens afterwards. The crusty hood has been painted, and I have spray painted it with flat varnish. And the interior section is also done. It's a bit blacker, more black in this this part, and I used some semi-gloss varnish for that because I really wanted to make a difference that looks different. We need to use SM screws to get this thing fixed. We're gonna do that right now, and after that's done, we're gonna add a few details on the front over here, and then we're gonna install the hinges. So first a screw at this one, and then the decorative front, and then we're gonna take a look at the hinges. We're gonna use RM screws for screwing in the hinges. They are marked R and L, so R goes over here. Well, another hint is of course that the spring goes inside of the hinge. So we're gonna use those screws, and it would be easier to screw them in when the hinges is closed, but I think I'm gonna do it like this. So let me put this into oil to make sure that it is nice and oiled before I'm gonna screw it in, because these need to be going in very sturdily. Okay, I need to close it a little bit so my screwdriver will be going in straight down instead of in an angle. Yeah, it is crooked, so I need to redo this and screw it in again, because it went in at an angle, which of course is not good. Okay, let's try this again with my other hand. I think it's going in straight now. Let's check. Yep, that's better. Okay, so we need to close the hinge a little bit so the screwdriver can go in a straight angle. Okay, that's in. I'll do the other one off camera. Okay, I got it in. Yeah, it took a bit of convincing, but the hinges are in, and I think it all is okay, because I can now easily open up the hood and it stays open. And allow me to show you what it looks like inside. This is what it looks on the inside. We got a bit of a problem, of course. The light of the sun is now actually working against me, but well, we'll see it in a later edition, and we can easily just close it, and it's closed. By the way, there is, let me open it again, there is some sort of a opening mechanism on over here with a tab. If you see, can oh, here it is, the tab, it looks like a hatch lock. I haven't actually seen it locking in. No, it doesn't lock in, but no, it doesn't lock in at all. But that should be it for now. That is weird, by the way. This is the pin. Oh, it doesn't lock in. Weird. Well, anyway, thank you so much for joining me. Next issue, we are going to take care of the roof and either one or both of these side panels, these front fenders.
But that'll be for next time. Thank you so much, and we'll see each other next time on Build the Ecto 1. The Ghostbusters do it
again. BNT. Custom made models and dioramas. Ha! Like you click and subscribe you must.